For a Minnesota project underway that's called Bugs Below Zero, you could argue that this winter may not seem the best match. But as Heidi Wigdahl finds out, the weather isn't as important as the goal to get people involved in community science.
In the dead of winter, life is everywhere. If you're curious enough to look for it.
Hello, everyone.
At Bellwing Conservancy in Afton.
Good morning, third graders. My name is Dean. I am what is called an entomologist.
St. Paul's Battle Creek Elementary is getting a lesson on bugs.
I think it's cool.
Being not afraid to be able to pick it up, these insects are harmless to us.
This is a giant stonefly. They live about 2 years underwater
an adult
before emerging with wings.
Very important in the stream for cleaning up the dead leaves.
They're cute.
Liam, Gloria, and Nawal are, like many kids, curious about bugs.
It's not scaring me no more.
How many gills were there on each side?
It's a curiosity the adults here hope lasts a lifetime.
So it's important to sort of pay attention to what's going on with our tiniest insects.
University of Minnesota Associate Professor Rebecca Swenson is part of a project putting insects at the forefront.
Bugs Below Zero is an education, outreach, and research program trying to get people excited and interested about streams in Minnesota and what the role of insects and fish are and the overall stream food webs.
You saw a bug? Cool.
Entomologist Alyssa Anderson is also on the team.
Do you see any places that insects might be hiding?
Helping share the story of the secret life of bugs.
They just provide an essential service to our ecosystem, and without some of these organisms, we don't know the cascading consequences that it might have.
It's why some researchers stay busy at streams in the winter.
Yeah.
Alyssa is an associate professor of biology at Southwest Minnesota State University in Marshall.
Maybe a little bit more.
Students are helping her research winter aquatic insects at Camden State Park.
Working in the winter is pretty novel. There's not a lot of ecologists that are out in the field during this time of year. So that means there's a lot of questions that are not answered.
Students scoop samples out of the stream from a Hester Dendy, basically a bug hotel.
Put this fake rock in there so they can colonize it.
Typically, these winter bugs are easy to spot on snowbanks.
No snow, which is very unique for a large portion of the winter. And as far as how that's impacting the insects, in the short term, we do know that they don't live as long during warmer temperatures. And if they're not living as long, there's not as many in the stream for fish and other organisms that might be feeding upon them.
It's good to like be able to inform people like the impact of the climate change and everything like that to our just local streams.
For those fishermen, if those fish don't have the food sources to survive through a harsh time of year, that's going to have consequences on the abundance of fish and how those fish are growing and developing.
Yeah, that should be pretty good.
Reasons
weird
to stay curious about bugs.
It's very enjoyable to be able to come out here and kind of play with the water and the bugs.
Oh no, I see another one, I see another one.
Curiosity one can lead to conservation.
It's crawling on my hand.
Tiny reminders of life in the dead of winter. In Afton, Heidi Wigdahl, CARE 11 News.
What a great program. Bugs Below Zero is housed at the U of M. Thanks to the Minnesota Lottery, it is funded through the Environment and Natural Resources Trust Fund. Now they want you to get involved to document the insects that you see in your streams during the winter months. We have more information on care11.com.